and today I'll show you three amazing ideas for Mother's Day. These ideas are healthy, are delicious, and are super beautiful. Make sure to stay until the end because I'm going to share with you some of the tips and tricks of how to make these three ideas, all three of them, in just under 30 minutes and with low budget ingredients. So let's talking and let's get started. Before starting, make sure to take a note of the ingredients because this is really important to prepare these ideas in just 30 minutes. So we will need 2 slices of sourdough, 1 small red onion, 1 large avocado, 1 chili, 1 lemon, salmon, I have just 100 grams of salmon, 2 organic free-range eggs, some basil and some fresh parsley, chia seeds, organic fresh milk, or you can use plant-based milk, 1 tablespoon of organic cocoa powder, vanilla paste, 1 spoon of honey, 1 banana, about 200 grams of strawberries, 150 grams of white chocolate, or you can use dark chocolate, and as well we will need vinegar and salt and pepper for all these recipes. And make sure as well to stay until the end because I'm going to share with you the 4th recipe for this, which is super easy and it will transform this breakfast or this idea into an amazing surprise. If you are new to my channel, welcome. Here I'm posting every Tuesday and every Friday new, interesting, healthy, quick and easy recipes. I hope you'll enjoy and let's get started. Firstly, start by placing 2 medium saucepans on medium heat. In one, put about 1 cup of water, and the other one, just fill about 2/3 of the saucepan. In the saucepan with more water, add about 1 tablespoon of vinegar. I used here red wine vinegar, but any vinegar would be just fine. In the saucepan with just 1 cup of water, we will use the double boiler method of melting the chocolate. Just make sure that the bowl doesn't touch the water. When the water started to boil on the double boiler improvised pan, reduce the heat to lowest and put 2/3 of the white chocolate in the bowl and mix it occasionally until completely melted. Do not keep it too long, otherwise the temperature will be too high and the chocolate will lose its tempering properties. While the chocolate melts, let's prepare the chia pudding. In a small mixing bowl, put the chia seeds, cocoa powder and the honey, or of course maple syrup, and add as well the milk. Make sure to stir everything is completely incorporated and let it sit for at least 15 minutes. A little secret here. If your chia seeds doesn't bloom in 20 minutes, most probably it's not good and you'll have to buy another good organic chia seeds. I'll link in the ones that I'm using in the notes below. Set the chia pudding aside and prepare the strawberries. In a large bowl with water, add some vinegar. Wash the strawberries thoroughly and pat dry with a clean kitchen towel. Keep the stems. And one more important thing here, the fresher the strawberries, the better. Mines are not the best quality, but most importantly, they are tasty. Here is an important step, dry the strawberries properly, otherwise the chocolate won't stick to them and you'll have these mushy, not beautiful strawberries. If the chocolate is completely melted, this shouldn't take more than 2-3 minutes as mentioned before. Remove it from the heat and stir it to ensure that there are no solid chocolate remaining inside. Add the rest of the chocolate in the melted chocolate, mix it together and let it sit for about 5 minutes. While the chocolate is on the side, let's make the poached egg. Now, in 2 glass jars or 2 small glasses, crack the eggs, 1 in each jar. And another little secret here is to use fresh organic eggs. The fresher the eggs, the better. While the water is boiling, reduce the heat to low or medium. By using a spoon, create a whirl in the middle and gently slide 1 egg at a time in the middle of the vortex. Let it spin by itself and cook until the egg white had mostly solidified. Here it will take about 2 to 3 minutes, depending on how hard you want your poached eggs. I prefer with a runny egg yolk. Now, remove the poached eggs with a spoon and repeat the process for the 2nd egg. The poached eggs are delicious with a cooked egg white and perfectly runny yolk. Put the eggs aside and let's get back to the chocolate. By now, all the chocolate should be melted and it's time for our strawberries.
To check if the chocolate is tempered, check its consistency first. It should slide from the spoon in beautiful, consistent ribbons. If it's too liquid, continue stirring until it gets to the right thickness, or if it's too thick, just place for about 10 to 15 seconds on the double boiler and it will increase a little bit the temperature. To coat our strawberries, just take one strawberry at a time, dip it into the white chocolate and place it on a parchment paper. Correctly tempered chocolate should solidify almost immediately and become shiny, just like this. Repeat for all the strawberries and sprinkle with some candy sparkles if desired. If not, you can leave them just the way how they are. They are beautiful and they are amazing. Put them in the fridge to set and let's go to the next recipe. Our next recipe is the avocado on toast. A full recipe on how to make guacamole I'll link in the notes. Start by peeling the red onion and chop it really finely. Depending on how spicy you'd like your guacamole, finely chop a half or maybe a full chili pepper. And then finely chop the parsley as well. Cut the lemon in half and use just half of the lemon, the juice of actually half of the lemon. Cut one large avocado in half, remove the seed and using a spoon, scoop the avocado in a mixing bowl. Add there as well the finely chopped onion, chili, squeezed lemon, a drizzle of olive oil, parsley, salt and pepper. Using a fork, mash the avocado and thoroughly combine all the ingredients. I'll share with you how to make cute cured salmon kind of roses. Using a glass, line up the salmon around the glass. I use here about 3-4 slices for each rose. And gently, using your hand, put upside down the glass and remove the salmon from this glass. Here you go, beautiful cured salmon roses. Now it's time for toast. Toast 2 slices of sourdough or toast of your choice and let's assemble our beautiful breakfast. But before that, I'll share with you the 4th amazingly good recipe and easy recipe mentioned at the beginning of this video. Freshly squeezed orange juice. Who doesn't like a freshly squeezed orange juice? I do. So I think everyone as well knows how to make it, but if you don't, no worries, I got you covered. Cut your oranges in half and using an orange squeezer, squeeze 4 or 5 oranges and transfer the juice into a glass. Sorry, I always spill some of the juice on the countertop. This always happens to me. But the good news. So let's get back to assembling. Firstly, for the chia pudding, cut one banana in slices and transfer the bloomed chia in a glass. Place the bananas on top and dish one is done. Now remove the strawberries from the fridge and transfer them into a cute small dish or bowl and set them aside. So now it's time for the avocado toast. This is easy. So place equal amounts of the guacamole on the toast and using a fork, spread it evenly on the toast. Now place the salmon roses on one side of the toast and after arranging them nicely, put the poached eggs with the nice side on top. Yes, the poached eggs, they have nice sides and they have this like kind of not so beautiful ones. For a beautiful last minute touch, drizzle with some extra virgin olive oil and this is ready to serve. And it's done! 4 amazingly beautiful dishes for Mother's Day. Let me know in the comments below which one would you prefer to make or which one you like the most. Believe me, this breakfast will be loved and it's worth 30 minutes of your precious time.
So this was my recipe ideas for Mother's Day. This is beautiful, it's amazing, it's tasty, it's super healthy as well. And believe me, she would be thrilled. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up, to subscribe if you are new to my channel. And see you in the next video. Thank you.